Hi and welcome. Intrusion Detection Systems, or IDS, detects any abnormal activity which is happening on your systems or on your network in real time and also in an automated manner. Now, Intrusion Detection System can be a software, or it can be a hardware, or it can be a service running on a security device, for example, firewall. In this video, I will discuss different categories of intrusion detection systems. So let's start. Before moving further, please turn on the subtitles for this video. Now, intrusion detection systems can be classified according to their deployment position in the network architecture and according to their detection technology they use and according to the response they provide to the attacks. So according to their deployment, they can be deployed at the host or at the network. So they are then called host-based intrusion detection systems or network-based intrusion detection systems. And according to the detection technology they use, they are called knowledge-based intrusion detection systems or behavior-based intrusion detection systems. And according to the response they provide to the attacks, these are called as passive response intrusion detection systems or active response intrusion detection systems. And once the active response intrusion detection systems is deployed in line with the network traffic, then it is called intrusion prevention systems, because it preemptively prevent an attack or blocks an attack. Now, the host-based intrusion detection system acts like an antivirus, and it is deployed at the endpoints to monitor any abnormal activity with regards to the system files or the processes, and also any virus propagation by using the removable media, for example, the USB devices. So host-based intrusion detection system can analyze the encrypted network traffic once it is decrypted at the host. So it can confirm the success of an attack. Moreover, there are certain overheads with the host-based intrusion detection systems on the system or upon which it is deployed. Moreover, there is no correlation which this host-based intrusion detection system can perform with regards to the activities happening on the other systems. And due to these overheads, the host-based intrusion detection system should only be deployed on key servers. Moreover, the host-based intrusion detection system can be detectable and can be disabled by the attacker, and attacker can also delete the logs which are only maintained on the same system. Now, the network-based intrusion detection system uses sensors to collect log data from the network devices, for example, switches and firewalls. Moreover, it also collects network traffic by using the port mirroring, where the entire traffic which is being processed by a switch is mirrored to a specific port on that switch. And this port mirroring is also known as span or switched port analyzer port, which is a Cisco term. Now, the application-based intrusion detection system is a special form of network-based intrusion detection system because it monitors and analyzes the web traffic or the traffic with regards to a specific application on the network. So the network-based intrusion detection system can correlate the events or the activities happening on other systems. And there are less overheads involved with the network-based intrusion detection systems because all the processing is performed on a central NIDS. Now the network-based intrusion detection system can also detect the denial of service attack or the distributed denial of service attack over the network, and moreover it backups its log data in case the attacker is able to compromise the local logs. So the log can be restored from the backup data. Now the botnet traffic is normally encrypted by using HTTPS. Therefore, the encrypted traffic is a major issue with the network-based intrusion detection systems because it cannot analyze the encrypted traffic. And in order to analyze these encrypted traffics, the network-based intrusion detection system uses a special feature known as SSL offloading or SSL decryption. But this feature is very costly, and there are certain overheads involved by using SSL offloading or SSL decryption. Now, with regards to the detection technology the intrusion detection system can use, the intrusion detection systems are the knowledge-based intrusion detection system, which uses a database of signatures for known malware or known attacks. For example, the signatures for sync flood attack or traffic, but it does not detect the zero-day attacks because it does not have signatures for new malware. So there should be an automatic update feature available on knowledge-based intrusion detection system so that it can update its signatures database. So knowledge-based intrusion detection systems are faster than behavior-based intrusion detection systems, and they are more accurate. Now the behavior-based intrusion detection systems are also called anomaly-based or statistics-based or heuristics-based or expert systems, because they use a baseline of normal activities which they have gathered over a period of time, for example a week, and based upon this baseline they can detect any deviation from this baseline as abnormal or malicious activity. So the stateful firewalls uses this behavior based technique because these firewalls maintain a state of the connections initiated from the internal network, and once the data is received from the external network, then they compare these traffic to see that whether the request was initiated by the internal host. So they see the context of this traffic. So they are also known as context-based intrusion detection systems. So they can detect the zero-day traffic. However, it requires more computation than the knowledge-based intrusion detection systems, and there are more false positives. And moreover, if you have modified your network, then you have to modify this baseline, otherwise you will get lot of false positives. Now the passive response intrusion detection systems does not stop the attack. It just log the attack and notify the administrator over the emails, text, or the pager. Now the network and moreover they can also display these alerts on network operating systems, and they are not in line with the network traffic. So they only notify the administrator and does not stop any attack. Whereas the active response intrusion detection system actively stop the attack. Or there are two kind of deployments for this active response, that is inline deployment and out of line, where they just mirror the traffic. So once they are deployed in line with the traffic, then they are known as intrusion prevention systems, because they can proactively stop or block the attack. And once they are not deployed in line with the traffic, then they can also stop the attack, but after it has occurred. So they basically modify the environment to block any attack, for example, modifying the access control list on your firewalls, or blocking the malicious ports or malicious IPs. So if any false positive occur on the active response intrusion detection system, then it is more expensive, because it can then cause self denial of service attack by blocking our legitimate traffic. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected to my channel for similar videos. Thank you.